Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Jacob Restituto, and I'm a musician from Northport, New York, and I'm pumped about this Olivia Rodrigo concert. I'm going to be doing each song individually, so you can watch them at your leisure. You can watch one, you can watch all of them, and pick the ones you want to watch if you don't want to watch every single one, for example. That being said, I'm pumped. So we're starting it off with Happier Deja Vu Mashup, which is a pretty cool thing. I love when artists mash up two of their songs together. I'm excited to see this kind of concert. I think it's just fun, a different style of, like, you know, performance video. That being said, before we get into it, I'm a huge fan, if you're not aware, of the show Hot Ones, which is where they eat those ridiculously hot spicy wings. It's actually where I got my show, the idea for my show Drinking with Jacob from. And I plan to watch Olivia. I watched so many of those, but I plan to watch Olivia Rodrigo's. But I'm going to be doing it on my Patreon. It's not something I want to post on my channel because I want to keep that separately. I'm also going to start doing more documentaries on my channel, music-related documentaries. So, like, for example, Taylor Swift or, like, BTS maybe or Shawn Mendes. So if you're interested in that, consider checking out the Patreon. It'll be available for all of the tiers in Patreon as well as so much other stuff. But let's see what we got. We're starting it off with Happier Deja Vu. I'm curious to start it off if this license plate, start right off with the license plate, is very interesting. And I have a feeling that it is probably some sort of Easter egg. I just don't entirely know what. Nice stereo guitars. I'm curious how, first of all, hold on a sec. Oh, exterior temperature is 86 degrees. I was going to say, who in the world keeps the temperature inside their limo 86 degrees? And here I am trying to be like 65 degrees in my car because, like, it's like 99 degrees in New York at the moment. So I was going to say, like, that person's crazy, but the external temperature, okay. A sour hour, that's pretty cool. So I'm curious to I don't know the answer to this. I wonder, it says live from sour. I wonder how much of it is actually live, because I mean that would be a producer's nightmare, because like there's so many moving parts between all the different scenes. So I don't know how live it actually is, if it is or if it's not. Talking about the production, we have some, like I said, I don't know, because we see one guitarist obviously, but you could hear that the stereo acoustics is one in the left ear, one in the right ear. And now talking her vocals, we have some pretty dry vocals going on, in the sense of not a ton of stuff going on. Not a ton of reverb, not a ton of echo, which could lend itself to being live. I guess actually the way to tell would be if she has in-ears in. If she has in-ears in the video, then it would probably be live. Because you wouldn't be able to get these extra stuff without her, like, it would cause, like, something called, like, it'd cause, like, essentially phase, issues. Actually, hold on a sec, listen. So listen to the P in hope. You can actually hear the p in it, which is actually very interesting. So like the air push, which gives it a bit more of that live feel, which it could be. I hope you're happy, just not like how you were with me. That's a sick mashup in there. Oh, cool change up in there. Instead of going to the that ridiculously high notes that she hits, she changes the melody right there. Song she's singing now when she's with you. That's cool. Do you get deja vu? I like that she changed the melody a little. Ah, crunchy guitars, man. Nice syncopation on there. So we're here doing like one and two and three, and if we were to pick up the guitar, I saw that she was playing an A chord, so it's probably like, yeah, it's something like this, like a D chord. Something like that. Or, yeah. Yep, I think it's D to A. So, but the one and two, but it's really a syncopated where we're emphasizing the and, like a one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and, giving that whole like emphasis right there on that. Those drums are so crunchy, it's so good, man. By crunchy, like distorted. Nice bass coming in. Mashup comes out fantastic. Oh, wait, hold on a sec. This might be a cue that it might not be actually live. You can hear a breath at the end of it, and the mic's away from her mouth. I don't know. I part of the reason I like to dissect this kind of stuff is, as an artist myself, sometimes I'm like, these artists are so crazy good live, and it's like, oh man, it stresses me out with how good they are. But I don't know. I the reason I want to talk about it is because if it's not, there's nothing wrong with it not being live. I just want people to realize it. So, because the problem I think that we have as a musical society is we sometimes say things are live when they're not, and that gives it's like essentially like the Instagram versus reality situation where like people are like, oh my gosh, like so and so is such a crazy good live singer, where it might be pitch corrected or might be edited in the studio, and like then we start thinking to ourselves, I'm not that good because I don't sound like that. Meanwhile, you're comparing your true live vocals to something that may not be live, and I'm not discrediting her at all, because I know she's a fantastic singer. I've seen her live performances, I'm just curious. So, but that is something that I'm actually pretty adamant about. Is like, if it's live, I want it to be known as live, because like I don't think it's fair to newer artists that they're comparing themselves to these artists that might have great voices, you know, but like it's not a true live performance. And I just think that it's like the Insta, like I said, going back to what I was saying, is like, you know, there's, there might be somebody on Instagram, you know, that is a beautiful person, but then they go in and edit all this stuff, and we think, oh my gosh, they look amazing. Meanwhile, they spent 20 minutes or 20 hours or however long, you know, editing all these crazy things. So it's like that comparison. Because listen right there, you can hear a breath in there, but the mic's over here. Hear the breath in? I don't know, that's just my opinion. So, but that's a killer, it was a killer track. But I really enjoyed it, so I hope you guys enjoyed that also. Thank you so much for watching. I think, I'm going to continue going through. So thank you so much for the for watching. I made it to the end of this video. If you want to check out the Hot One stuff, it's going to be on Patreon very soon. Probably going to film it within the next 3 days, or at least probably next day, two or three. So hope you guys are enjoying the content. Thank you so much. The best way to support the channel is checking out my personal music. Thank you guys. You guys rock. Have a great day. God bless and peace.